right. Very positive day yesterday for NHL fans, correct?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, the one thing I have been prefacing everything is that this does not mean that hockey is back, but it gives us a format of what it will look like potentially if hockey gets back. And so that's exciting to actually be writing about, you know, Minnesota Wild versus Vancouver Canucks potential possibilities and things like that, and actually something that could potentially be real rather than, you know, kind of extending our creativity to the nth degree and coming up with all these story ideas that, you know, just to try to keep our readership engaged and things like that. Now we actually are writing about stuff that actually could potentially happen.
So what's next?
Well, that's a good question. I mean, really what next is over the next couple of weeks, the NHL Players Association and the National Hockey League are going to have to negotiate everything that around what will these games entail, what will the hub cities be like, what will this quarantine that the players are going to have to go to, you know, how strict and stringent will that be? You know, these players are very concerned about being away from their families. What will this isolation be like? Are they, if they go and check into a hotel in Edmonton or Vancouver or here in the Twin Cities or Vegas, are they going to be able to leave the hotel? Can they only eat in their hotel rooms like Major League Soccer? Will it only be, you know, hotel to rink back? Who will be in this quarantine? You know, a lot of players have talked to me about the you know, how they want to know if they're holed up because of safety and can't be around their families. It doesn't make sense if all of a sudden bus drivers and housekeepers and hotel clerks and chefs and custodial staff go back to their families, back into leave this bubble and come back and they bring in COVID-19. What is the purpose of a bubble then? And you know, this is the type of stuff that the NHL is going to have to negotiate with the NHL Players Association. Testing is a huge issue. The NHL did say yesterday that they will bear the brunt of the cost. But if you have 12 teams in the Twin Cities, and that is going to, with the amount, if you do the math of tests that they're going to have to do for these players, and we're talking thousands and thousands, tens of thousands of tests, at a cost of millions of dollars, are you taking away tests from the general society of people here in the Twin Cities? That is stuff that, from a perception wise, would not be good. So this is all tight. There are so many issues that still have to be negotiated, and then eventually that will have to go to the players to be canvassed and approve it to actually begin training camp by early July.